Hello everyone, welcome to yet another amazing class. Today we are going to be entering lesson 2. Our learning targets are: I can read consonants and vowel sounds in the code flip books, but we're going to make use of our individual code charts. Now, I can detect words using different spellings. I can ask and answer questions about key details in the story, the camp site. The last time we talked about how Kate went to visit her nan for the holidays and she wasn't finding it interesting, and now she is going to a campsite because she was asked to go on a camping with her grandma and Jake and his grandson. So let's move over to the next slide. Before that, we are going to review our spellings. We are going to review the sounds we treated in our flip book. Now, we have the R sound and we have the WOON sound. The WOO sound, the R sound as in HAR, R, HAR, R, HAR. We all know that the R sound has the ER digraph. And we also have the WOO sound as in WHEN, WOO as in WHEN, WOON as in WHEN. Now we have the A sound as in hat. The A sound as in hat, and the hat is spelled H-A-T, hat. As is pronounced ha-a-t, H-A-T, hat. The next one is the E sound as in eat. The E sound as in eat. Now we have vowel sounds like ah and E. Remember we said this in our last video, we said that A and E are made up with an open mouth. You can't say A and E without opening your mouth. A, E. You can see that my mouth is opened. A, E. A, E. You can't make the sound A and E if your mouth is not open. So it says here that vowel sounds like A and E are made with an open mouth. Let's review the vowel sound. Now you can see A, E, E, R, and O. A, E, E, R, and O. So A as in heart. A as in heart. If you're not able to pronounce this, pronouncing the words alone can help you pronounce sounds. Ah, ha, at, ha, at, ah, heart. We have e, it, e, it. E, it. We have e, pet, e, pet. You see, you can hear my sounds and you can hear me pronounce those sounds or sound those sounds as I pronounce the word. E, pet. We have the R as in bot, but. We have the or hop, or hop. So like I always say, if you don't know sounds, you won't be able to pronounce words. You have to learn sounds, it will help you pronounce words. Without sounds, words cannot be pronounced. Without sounds, words cannot be formed. So you need to learn sounds. This individual code chart book is going to help you learn sounds and learn how to pronounce words. So like I said before in our last video that you're going to use the green marker to mark the vowel sounds, while the red marker is to mark the consonant sounds. And this is going to help you to know which is the vowel sound and which is the consonant sound. So let's move on to the next slide. Open your individual code chart and read the sounds over and over again. It's going to help you know how to pronounce words and know how to sound. Now let's take a look at some spellings in the consonant code flipbook. Again, when we look at those cards, it is important to talk about the sound the letters make. The sound the letters make. The power bar and the word that have the spellings. So let's look at the sounds, the consonant sounds. We have the k. 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 It's pronounced k. But sometimes we, k and k, c and k have the same sound sometimes. So we have k and k. K, which is the k, as in kite. K, kite. Kite. Why the c is cat. So it makes the same sound most times. We have g. G, g, as in gift, k, gift, k, gift, g, as in gift. Now, like I said, you're going to be using the red marker to mark our consonant sounds for our individual code chart. Now, let's look at our individual code charts. You can see k. We can see k as in cut, k as in kid, black as in k, k as in black. We have the g sound as in gift. We also have the g sound as in egg, egg, egg. We have the g sound as in guest. We have the g sound as in ghost. So these sounds are going to help you learn spellings as well, because without these sounds, you won't be able to spell. Teachers chaining. We're going to be chaining again. Yes, in this video, we're going to learn how to chain again. And what did we say about chaining in our last class? I said you can chain words by changing, taking away, or adding a single letter or sound. You can chain words by changing, taking away, or adding a single letter or sound. Now we have kid, lead, lad, lag, log, jog, jet, vet. I said while chaining, you either remove, add, or change. As you can see, the first chaining part, you see kid, what was removed? K was removed. So we added L to chain. We added what? L to chain. And removed what? K. And that gave us lead. Remove the vowel and added, remove the vowel I and added A, which gave us the word lad. We have lag, log, jog, jet, and vet. The second part of the chain, we have lap, lad, hard, heed, bead, bird, beg, bog, hug, and log. So if you look at this, it's going to help you learn how to chain words. Remember I said you can either chain word by removing, adding, changing letters. So this is basically how to chain words. Dictation. Please take out a pencil and a piece of paper. I'm going to say some words. After I say the words, you will write it on your paper. I will say each word twice and will sound it out slowly. You may use your individual code charts as a quick reference during this activity. Number one, Pete. 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 Number two. Teep. 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 Number three. Beep. 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 Do you know what beep is? Beep is that thing they put on the neck of a baby that helps to prevent stains from touching the baby's clothes when the baby is about to eat. That's what beep is. So beep. Beep. The calm sight. The calm sight. We are going to practice reading a story about Kate and her adventure in the West. Who is Kate visiting? Well, we all know that Kate went to visit her nan, which is her grandmother. Her grandmother is her nan. Please turn to page worksheet 2.1 of your workbook. Let's read the title of the story. Remember, the title gives us an idea of what the story is about. Campsite. Campsite. A campsite is a place you set up your tent when you go camping. It's a place where you set up your tent when you go camping. What job has to be done to set up a campsite? Remember, you need to get the sticks, get everything needed to set up a campsite. Put the cover. The cover there is to make you protected from insects and wild animals. So, let's start reading. Let's read the text closely together. Just like yesterday, sometime I will read it alone. So, let's start. The campsite. Jake came and picked us up in his Jeep. We drove to a campsite in the Badlands. Nan, I said, what's up with the name, the Badlands? Well, said Nan, legend has it that a long time back, farmers came out here looking for farmland. When they saw all of the rocks and the sand and stone, they said, this is Badland. We can't plant crops here. And the name Badland came sort of stuck. It's bad land for farming, said Jack. But it's good land for camping. When we got to the campsite, we had to unpack sleeping bags, tents, lanterns, matches, and lots of food.
We lugged it all to the campsite.
Jake chose a spot to set up camp. Max and I helped set up the tent. It took us a long time. For dinner, we had hot dogs. We stuck them on sticks and held them in the fire. My hot dog got all black because I left it in there too long. Max gave me one of his. That was when I said to myself, this Max kid is okay. I hope you enjoyed the reading. Now let's answer questions from the story together. First one is, who drove the Jeep to the campsite? The second one is, why was the place called Badland? The third one, who set up the tent? The fourth one, why did Kate's hot dog get black? Then the last one, in the end, what did Kate think of Max? Now you have to do well by answering the questions on worksheet 2.2. And have a wonderful time. I hope you enjoyed the class. Bye, to see you in our next video. Have a nice day.